not pre-cooked.
If you got pre-cooked, then all you're doing is warming them
up.
Okay. Absolutely.
We're going to take another quick break, and we're going to be right back with more of Flavors of Ethnic Cooking. Lonnie, myself, Vernon, after these messages. Bad you can't bump in on the smell.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I see
this. This is the brown. That's what you want. You want to get the brown. Don't be afraid to hold them when you flip them. I'll make sure they don't fall apart. Okay. But you want to get that. You see that brown on them.
And now you want the other side, right?
Just a little. And again, depends on your skillet. This is a non-stick skillet, so I don't need to use as much. If not, you may use a little more because you don't want them sticky. And basically now, I'm just wanting this to cook through another 3 minutes and we'll be good on that. And the turkey, I'm about to turn down because I checked the temperature and we pretty much are there. Okay. So we're in pretty good shape now.
Let me show folks what I have here. I have in the fruit salad, there's some blueberries in there. There's some bananas, there's apple. And I'm gonna put my two little secret ingredients in them. And,
excellent.
Everybody eat nuts, okay? Well, don't forget that there's some people who are allergic. Some of the kids are allergic to nuts, so that's something that you have to check, particularly if you're having company. You wanna check because you don't wanna spoil your Father's Day and have to be sitting in the emergency room. But, and once again, it's to your liking. I like nuts, so but I'm just gonna go ahead and just put a few in there. You can put them later. And then I put my other secret ingredient. Not a lover of yogurt.
How much do you put?
You know, I basically judge just by the look. There is no set amount. And with yogurt, you can get, thank you, you can get peach. You get strawberry, you get the plain,
you get the flavor.
And a lot of times, if I can't find a particular fruit, I'll get the yogurt in that flavor. Hmm. Being that the only thing, they didn't have peach when I went, I was hoping they had peach, so I bought strawberry. And then I'll just go ahead and put it in like that. And then I mix it up. And once again, it's one of those things that's to your liking.
One of the last things we do is cut the sausage, and if you're smart, which I'm not being, you would probably want to use a towel because they're still hot, and I'm just splitting them like a hot dog, and you can cut them up depending on how many people are eating them and things of that nature, and you get a little better presentation. You can flip them, you can cut them this way, any way you want to, and then cut them up sometimes. You know, because you don't want waiting, I'll cut them like this. So basically, you get four pieces out of one, similar to what you want with bacon. Mm-hmm. Now and I'll do the rest with those,
the
too.
The interesting thing is someone was, wasn't Lonnie, but someone mentioned, do you put cinnamon or nutmeg in them? They happen to be liker of cinnamon or nutmeg.
So in your fruit salad?
Mm-hmm. So you can put it in there. I don't. But what you think about it, and you can.
You can. And some people put honey and other things
and
in,
some
in their
put,
salad.
Right. But some people will put honey. So, once again, that's the great thing about something
like
this.
But the fruit is really where you're getting your sugar from.
The fruit is where you're getting more than enough sugar from. So I'm going to just go ahead. And you can make it as much or as little as you want. For one person, use one apple. I used 2.5. I usually use 3. You can use a couple of bananas. And you see how much I've gotten? From this, I use a whole package of blueberries because blueberries are good for you as well as strawberries.
One of the great things about doing that, if it's not all eaten, you'll eat it. You can have it for lunch on Monday for
That's
the kids.
True. And then you can take it to lunch with you. I tell you what, why don't we take that final break, and when we get finished with this, we'll be sitting down, and you know what I always say about it, right? It's all in the taste.
It is.
You know, it can look as good as you want it to be, and so we have some harsh critics here today. So we'll know. So once again, I'm done fruit salad, turkey sausage, croissants.
Croissants are done.
And little greedy guts over there.
So we're gonna those are the people who don't want to go on air because they've been doing things.
They've been doing things. So we're going to be right back. Definitely don't touch that remote. We'll be right back with more Focus and the Flavors of Ethnic Cooking after this message. I know you don't do it
usually, but dear Lord. My name is Jay Rominger, and I'm a CASA volunteer here in the state of Arizona.
Jay has helped me in every part of my life.
CASA is a court-appointed special advocate. You advocate for children who have no one else to speak for them in court.
He's one of my top friends in the world.
He wants a family. He wants to be adopted. He wants a mom and a dad and normality.
It's really because of the Arizona Lottery funding that we are able to serve these children that need a voice, that need a Jay in their life.
Back when I was a child.
Okay, welcome back. Okay, let's
see. I've warmed up a little syrup.
Got you. Go ahead. I'm gonna. We have a fruit salad here: strawberries, blueberries, apples, bananas, walnuts, and yogurt. Then we made croissant toast instead of French toast because we made it with croissants. I just once I did it years ago and just fell in love with it. And then we're using. Turkey sausage instead of the normal pork sausage, and I'm pretty sure Lonnie, since he's down the road there,
and we've tasted it before. It's very good.
It's very good.
It's very good. Very flavorable. No seasoning.
And let me just also add that once, since we've using French toast, which is very, using croissants, very buttery. We didn't put any butter on the on the toast. Right?
No.
So, once again, tomorrow is Father's Day, and we want to wish everybody a good Father's Day. How's your dad doing?
He is. He's good. I know the show is seen in Tucson, so I want to take this opportunity to wish my father, Lonnie James Williams Sr., a special Father's Day everyone. And.
Tony, we have to wish Mr. Escobar Sr., who's our trusty, dusty cameraman and editor, and who without help would show would never get on the air. We want to wish him a happy Father's Day. And we just want to, once again, as I said at the beginning, it doesn't have to be a blood male. It could be someone who's just kind, a next door neighbor, a male who's just very kind and loving and sharing and stuff to you, so we definitely want to.
And by the way, happy Father's Day to you.
To you too.
Excellent.
Yes, absolutely. We don't want to forget about ourselves. So once again, as you enjoy the music and hopefully enjoy us eating, have a good day tomorrow. We have a good week, and we look forward to seeing you next week, same time, same station, when Focus continues. So I guess it's good, huh?
Very good. I pray for her even more than me. I pray for her even more than me.
She